Hello everyone. How many of you present here wanted to be artists, painters? So what is the reason you didn't do it? Sorry? Okay. The main reason I find out, the parents say, ki, how will you do your living? पेंटिंग करके कोई पेट कैसे भर सकता है यार. सो दैट इज़ द मेन इश्यू. सो आई एम बॉर्न इन अ फैमिली विच हैज़ बीन वेरी रिच इन आर्ट एंड कल्चर. माई ग्रेट ग्रैंड फादर यूज टू हैंडक्राफ्ट पैठनी सारीज एंड माई ग्रैंड फादर ही वॉज अ मास्टर इन वाटर कलर्स एंड ही वॉज एन आर्ट प्रोफेसर. माई फादर करंटली वर्क्स इन स्कल्पचर एंड पेंटिंग बोथ एंड वी बोथ वर्क इन आवर आर्ट स्टूडियो इन अहमदनगर. Since childhood, I have been playing in clay and colors. So, and I received a scholarship in sculpture when I was in the 7th grade. After passing my 10th boards, I took admission to a one-year foundation course in Ahmednagar. And later on, I did a four-year sculpture diploma from Pune. The next year, these are some of my college works. The next year, I went to the Florence Academy of Arts in Italy to do my master's in realistic portraits. When I returned back from Florence and I started working in my studio with my father, very soon I realized that each of my work is getting compared with my father's work, you know. So people are like, no, we want your father to work for us. You don't want your work, it's not that mature or it's not on that level. So I decided to do something unique that would create my own identity in my field. So I came up with the idea of how to make hand-painted movie posters. Because in today's times, you see, there are photos that are collaged in the movie posters and it's everything is based in digital media. So I thought, why not do it in hand-painted, like there were in the late 60s or the 70s. There was no digital media, there was no flex printing. Each and every poster was done using hands. So these are some of my studio works. So these are the movie posters that I started, that I came up with the ideas. So this is the first ever 3D movie poster I did of the movie Bajirao Mastani. And later on, I did many more movie posters such as Fan, Bajrangi Bhaijaan, Sultan, Manji, and many, many more. I also had a beautiful opportunity to work for Mr. Sachin Tendulkar's house in Mumbai and also for his farmhouse in Lonavala. So in today's digital and modern world, it is very important that you should keep classical art alive. You know, so in today's world, modern art is getting a bit more attraction because it attracts more money. So I think classical art should be given more and more of an importance because classical art is based in India. Modern art has come from the Westerns to India. It is not based in India. So you see, Michelangelo could tell us a bigger story of human body and beauty without us speaking Italian. So you can see what is the power of classical art. You know, art is art. You don't need any language to get connected with it. Every year during Ganpati festival, I teach nearly 50,000 students in different cities of how to make your own eco-friendly Ganpati Murti. The clay used in the Murti is 100% eco-friendly clay. The Ganpati idol that is made during the festival, that idol is worshipped for the 10 days in their homes and then it is immersed in water. As the clay used is 100% eco-friendly clay, it dissolves in water in just 2 hours. So this is my way to save nature from getting polluted. This is the eco-friendly clay. Now, I will give you a short demonstration of what type of clay I use, and it will be a just rough sketch of a character. So I'll start soon. The clay which I am using right now, it comes to me in powder form. You have to just mix water in it and it will become like this. Thank you. the sculpture I am doing over hello the sculpture I am doing over here, it is a routine of my daily practice. So I do some rough sketches in clay every day to make my skill more and more updated. So now, I am going to finish this very soon. Thank you. So this is a small ode to the unsung heroes of our country, our farmers who work hard day and night for us. Thank you.